Thank you so much for choosing to spend time to hear these wonderful little musicians. They've been working hard. I know they've been working hard because I teach in a classroom directly on the opposite side of the wall to beginning band. And what we've heard this week compared to what we've been hearing in chemistry class in September is amazing. So please enjoy and just think good thoughts about how wonderful our Savior is to have come to earth at this season so that we could live in heaven with Him forever. Will you join me in prayer? Lord, You're good. There are so many things that pull for our attention and time, and yet You're still so good and so patient. Thank You for the gift of Your Son, and that this is the season we can remember when He came as a little baby, so that He could grow and take His seat on the throne in heaven next to You. So Lord God, thank You, and I pray that we'll be blessed and that we will be a blessing to You tonight as these musicians play. In Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you. We're so glad you came tonight. We have a combination of three bands playing and a few solos and ensembles. How many of you noticed that we had some snow and ice out there? Yeah, it kind of messed us up. We only missed 3 days of rehearsals. And so we're going to have to do some little changes in the program for things that we couldn't quite get together in time because we missed those days. But we still have a great program for you, and we're really glad you're here to listen to us and to enjoy the hard work that we've been doing. And we hope to come back in the spring when we'll be even better. These kids have been playing for just 2.5 months. They started on a zero, so that's good. We're going to start off with a solo, a piano solo by Kylie Woodruff-Langer. Kylie's going to be playing an arrangement of the Ukrainian Bell Carol. And we're going to close the program with the band playing an arrangement of the Ukrainian Bell Carol. So, see the symmetry there? Alright, Kylie is a 7th grader, and she also plays baritone saxophone in concert band. Take it away, Kylie. Stick to their parts and not get confused by the other. That's big step forward. All right.
go. Thank you.
of the program and all of that. Savannah Reeves got left out of on the list of players. She's in there as a flute player, but you might have noticed her playing the bassoon over there. She has been a flute player for a couple of years, this is her second year, right? And decided that she wanted a little challenge. So in concert band, she's continued to play the flute, and she just decided to take up bassoon about 3 weeks ago? Two or 3 weeks ago, okay. So parents rented her bassoon, and now she's a bassoon player. So I'm sorry her name's not in there. Those of you who are taking those programs home and putting them in the baby books or the boxes or whatever to save forever, you'll have to pencil that in. Savannah Reeves, bassoon.
Thank you. is that we can only have one concert band, and so that takes all the musicians who are interested and have played fiddle up from 6th grade on up through 12th grade. This year we have a range of 6th through 11th grade in the band. We have a 7th grader who just started on our instrument. We have an 11th grader who's been playing for 6 years, 8 years? Yeah, you can imagine the challenge that is for the kids, especially the experienced kids. For the young students who really have to work to meet that higher level, and for me, finding music that we can all play. But it's a lot of fun too, as I see the younger kids really rise to the occasion. So we're going to play 4 pieces for you, and I think we'll just play them without introduction. I might say something about the last song before we go, but we'll just play. We'll start with Largo by Anton Dvorak.
Maybe you'll do a solo question. What do you think?
No. version of the Ukrainian bell carol. And one of the students did a little bit of research on the Ukrainian bell carol for us, just to find out a little bit about the background, because it is one of the most widely used, arranged, sung, performed Christmas carols of all. And he found out that it actually didn't start out as a Christmas carol. In Ukraine, it was an old folk song that was to welcome in the spring. They used it for the New Year, but their New Year is in April. And so if you go to Ukraine and you sing this little song, they look for Christmas, they look at you like, what are you doing? It's not spring. This is to bring the blessing into the home for the spring. It was an English-speaking American composer who actually wrote the Christmassy words to it that we know. So it will always be a Christmas carol to us because it sounds like bells ringing, and that's what he heard with that little four-note ditty and wrote about the bells ringing, and so now it's a Christmas song. But don't try to sing it for Christmas in Ukraine. They'll laugh at you.
So worth it. So we appreciate that support as well.